First of all, I would like to acknowledge the presence of the chief, head of mission from Canberra. And we really appreciate their presence here. It has meant a lot to the government of Fiji. Also, we would like to acknowledge, and I am thankful on behalf of government, and I convey government's deepest appreciation and gratitude to IOM, International Organization for Migration, in this commitment, traveling from very far to be able to bring in these relief items to Fiji. This has shown IOM's commitment to humanity, irrespective of where disaster strikes, in whichever part of the world, irrespective of the people affected, you are able to launch from, probably I have heard that this plane was launching from Manila, coming in from that far to reach the islands of Fiji. In the event of one of the worst weather hazard that has struck Fiji, causing this disaster. We all know the impact of the disaster itself and the impact that it has on the ground and the people affected by it. And we are still trying to come to terms with this impact. We are moving around and we are trying to push relief items to those who need it the most. And the arrival of this plane here this morning is a big relief to the Fiji government. It is indeed a boost. Looking at the manifest, you have what Fiji really needs now to assist the affected public, both on mainland and also in our maritime zone. As you would have known, our minister responsible for disaster management is wanting to move this consignment back to capital. He's looking at the rehab and rehabilitation and reconstruction phase, where these items and equipment could be better utilized. But a discussion along the corridors, I was going to ask the minister if I can actually use some of this stuff right now, because there are people who need it the most here in the Western Division. We still have a shortfall on how we respond in terms of giving out temporary shelters. Here in the Western Division, we are good with rationing, but in terms of temporary shelters, to actually move people out of the evacuation centers back to their respective places and for them to, and be able to support them to rebuild back their lives and to stand on their own 2 feet and move ahead, move forward. With this assistance, we will be able to do that in a much faster and efficient way. And I thank the IOM for that.
First, on behalf of our Director General and staff of IOM, we would like to extend our sincere condolences to the lives which have been lost through this tragic event, and also to express our solidarity and support to the government in helping to bring relief to the people whose lives have been devastated, and also to help rebuild their lives. It is really comforting to see how welcoming IOM has been in this country. We didn't have a presence prior to this event, but in the immediate aftermath of that, our new head of office was appointed, and she's been able to work with the government and all the international partners to make this possible, this support possible. This is not an IOM only effort. It is the effort of the international community as well and all the partners involved. And this is only the beginning or a restart of our support to the government of Fiji. This consignment which has arrived hopefully will help people rebuild their lives and also to resuscitate economic well-being and the dignity of the communities which have been affected. We work with the government in in the long haul to be able to bring recovery to these communities, help rebuild their lives, and also to revitalize all the different parts of the economy through this effort in order to for lives to be sustained. So we want to thank you and reassure you that this is only the beginning of a lifelong mutual engagement between IOM and the government and people of Fiji. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir.
Okay.
Thank you.